Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to MPWF Annihilation. We are starting things off a little differently here as General Manager KK Kwam is in the ring and he says, welcome to Annihilation. I have a couple announcements I need to make first regarding the main event scene and the MPWF Championship at SummerSlam. Folks, I'm your host, Dwayne James Johnny Feelgood, and we are going right into the action here for Annihilation. KK Kwam here to discuss the main event scene heading into SummerSlam, folks. This is episode 2 on YouTube. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Kwam says, tonight we were supposed to have a triple threat match to determine the number one contender for the MPWF World Title, but thanks to a constant war between Angel Ortiz and Ivan Volkov, that has not happened. That is right. Ortiz was screwed out of the number one contendership match by Ivan Volkov, and then Ortiz screwed Ivan Volkov out on the last episode, causing a lot of strife in this title scene. KK Kwam says those two cannot be allowed anywhere near the MPWF Championship until the battle between them is resolved. I thought long and hard on how I'm supposed to get a clear winner between them. A match that will make both men prove who is better. Two very, very proud men who want to find out who is the better, the master or the student. Kwam says Ortiz and Volkov will fight each other in a match that I will call Ultimate Honor at SummerSlam. No interference or else that man or woman will be barred from challenging for any title for the next year. Anything goes in the match so both men can do as they see fit to each other. And the only way to win is by submission, leaving the winner unquestionably. Ladies and gentlemen, Ultimate Honor between Angel Ortiz and Ivan Volkov. A huge announcement there by KK Kwam for SummerSlam. He says that later tonight, Ortiz and Volkov will have a contract signing for that match. Both men, once they have signed, will agree to not touch each other until SummerSlam. So next, we need to determine what we are going to do with the MPWF Championship at SummerSlam. And I know that's something everybody who wants to know, all Annihilation fans, especially with the Core World title on the war side of things. KK Kwam says, instead of a triple threat number one contenders match, I have decided to create two major matches tonight. The first match will be the number one contenders match. The Cypher will face Lethal Mathematics. And the main event will see Ryan Sparks defend the MPWF title against Benson Clement. All of this here live tonight on MPWF Annihilation, ladies and gentlemen. Two huge match announcements to lead into our main event for SummerSlam for MPWF Annihilation. Two massive matches. The winner of those two matches will face each other for the MPWF title at SummerSlam. Now with that said, I've talked too much. This is a wrestling show. Our opening match will be the Cypher versus Lethal Mathematics. Let's see who will become the number one contender. Well folks, you heard it right there from KK Kwam. Ultimate Honor between Angel Ortiz and Ivan Volkov at SummerSlam. Coming up next, the Cypher will meet Lethal Mathematics in a number one contendership match for the MPWF title, as well as our main event tonight will be Ryan Sparks versus Benson Clement for the MPWF World Championship. All of this here on episode 2 of Annihilation. And here we go, folks. This may be one of the wildest shows in MPWF history that KK Kwam has cooked up here. Once again, to reiterate, here in Birmingham, Alabama, we have Lethal Mathematics versus the Cypher in the number one contendership match for the World Championship. As well as the main event, we'll see Ryan Sparks defend the championship against Benson Clement. The winner of those two matches will compete for the MPWF World title at SummerSlam, our next clip review. Not only that, we have a contract signing for the first ever Ultimate Honor matchup at SummerSlam between Angel Ortiz and Ivan Volkov, still to come as well. We have semi-finals action in the Women's Tag Team title tournament, as well as the Avenger will defend the Hardcore Championship against Billy Ray Peterson, folks. What an episode we have for you here. We are not playing around. We're not pulling any punches. The MPWF is firing on all cylinders before SummerSlam. And this is one hell of a first time matchup. An opportunity for one of these two men to go to SummerSlam to compete for the richest prize on MPWF Annihilation, and arguably the richest prize in the entire MPWF and all of core wrestling. The lethal mathematics has been in this situation before, a multi-time MPWF world champion, but this man right here, what a 15-man Royal Rumble matchup on our previous episode. The Cypher got to this opportunity where he has never had a shot at a world championship here in the MPWF. The current Fight Japan Core Wrestling Eastern Champion, the Cypher can change his career forever tonight. On our previous episode, it was step one, win the Rumble. Step two, win the number one contendership match. Step three, win the MPWF title at SummerSlam. The ball is in this kid's court. The man from Queens, New York, to compete against one of the very best core wrestling has ever seen in lethal mathematics. Again, crazy that this is how we are starting things off here on Annihilation. Folks, I'm going to take a drink of water before this one gets started. I'm going to tell you that right now. This one's going to be wild. Again, if this is your first night here watching the MPWF, thank you and welcome. Again, chat, what's up? It's good to see you all here live for the MPWF. A big reaction from both of these men here tonight. Big time fan favorites here on MPWF Annihilation. Again, only one man could become the challenger for the MPWF title at SummerSlam. And there you have it, number one contendership matchup, Lethal Mathematics versus the Cypher. And Lethal going right after the Cypher. And again, who would have thought that Lethal Mathematics would have been the present and the veteran in this situation, that there would be a wrestler that is coming up just like him. From watching Lethal Mathematics back in the MPWF over 10 years ago, to seeing him in this situation now, where he's trying to get back to the MPWF world title, and a big time slam there, as he's facing a challenger, younger and arguably hungrier than he is. And look at that there with that deadlift powerbomb by the Cypher. Now I know Lethal's not gonna like that comment of the Cypher being hungrier than he is, and Lethal's gonna prove that he's hungrier than everyone on Annihilation. I mean, a lot going into it for Lethal Mathematics. If he wins tonight, he will either face his teammate Ryan Sparks for the MPWF world title, or face the leader of the undead, the leader of the void, Benson Clement. It is gonna be a tough task either way for any of these two men to become the MPWF world champion at SummerSlam. As Lethal hooks a leg for the cover here on the Cypher. Lethal was banned from competing for the MPWF world title for over a year, ladies and gentlemen, and that finally ended after WrestleMania, and already Lethal could be challenging for the world title in his first clip preview after that event. The Cypher, though, not a step below Lethal Mathematics in this matchup whatsoever. And I waited, drop kick miss there. And now wait, Cypher has him up. There's a beautiful T-bone suplex. And now the Cypher picking Lethal Mathematics up here, firing back with these strikes. And again, with the right hooks to Lethal Mathematics. And now what's the Cypher going for here? The Cypher clotheslining Lethal to the floor. And wait a minute, the Cypher might be going high risk here. The Cypher to the outside, oh my God! The Cypher putting it all on the line here, folks. The opportunity to be the number one contender for the MPWF world title is massive. A and the Cypher just hit a spaceman plunger on Lethal Mathematics. And like I said, this boy is starving. This boy is hungry. This boy wants to make it to the top of this industry, folks. As he hooks a leg here on Lethal, and Lethal gets the shoulder. My goodness, I wasn't expecting that here. What a way to kick off this night, folks. Again, I'm here with you. I don't know how long my voice is going to hold up with this action, folks, but we are going to be here till the very end. Now, a strike there by Lethal Mathematics. And Lethal now needing to change the momentum back to his side in this match. Lethal with a collar elbow tie up now, and Lethal going for the famous, and he hits it. Hooking that leg does Lethal Mathematics. Go for the cover. Oh my goodness. I mean, some people have questioned whether Lethal still has it in the ring. Again, I think he proved that when he ended the undefeated streak of Zeus at WrestleMania. But so far for the Cypher, the Cypher has picked up major victories, but the biggest ones he hasn't been able to get. Notably Bloodlines against Richard Hawkins. A United States title matchup against Lethal's brother, Sean Stevens. And what a move that was before there. We don't want to ignore that. As Lethal on the top rope here now. Oh my goodness. And the Cypher doesn't want to fall short again to Lethal Mathematics here on this second episode. It's Lethal now. Right back to that collar elbow. Tie up, switch it. There's a Russian leg sweep. Beautiful move there by the man of tomorrow with the gadgets to win today. Two. And a kick out there by the Cypher. KK Kwam is utilizing this MPWF Annihilation roster incredibly. And there's a chin lock. Knee in the back here by Lethal Mathematics. He's not going to get the Cypher to tap out from the chin lock, but what it's going to do is wear the Cypher down. Lethal with Mathematics is a big boy, folks. And having his weight on the Cypher's going to stop him, but there's a spy buster. Cypher now hooking the leg here on Lethal with a kick out. And the Cypher now hitting the ropes, building that momentum. That's what this matchup is going to be all about. Momentum, momentum, momentum. As the Cypher now heading to the top rope here. We've seen him use the 450 splash. One of his favorite moves. And now the Cypher there. Oh, double axe handle right to the spine of Lethal Mathematics. And now the Cypher got Lethal here. And look at this. Cypher showing off his strength. We mentioned the fact Cypher putting on some size right at WrestleMania time. Again, Cypher, even though hasn't got some of the victories that he's wanted, let's not forget he won the Royal Rumble matchup from number one on our previous episode. He defeated Japanese legend Takagi to become the Eastern Champion. The Cypher, a former World Wrestling Future Champion, former Hardcore and Cruiserweight Champion, is no slouch and is the future of this business. Let's now wait a minute. Beautiful Northern Light suplex there by Lethal Mathematics to the Cypher to kick out. Back and forth is this matchup here. And now there's a basic addition by Lethal Mathematics. And Lethal not even going for the cover this time. Signaling for the end here to the Cypher. Lethal now heading to that top rope here. Perhaps to go for the shooting star press. And if he hits it, it'll be all set and done it. Oh, the Cypher moved out the way of the shooting star press. And a kick to the gut here. And now the Cypher has Lethal Mathematics up. And he's got him for the last ride power bomb. And he's looking at the leg here. One, two, and oh my goodness gracious me. A slight mistake there by Lethal Mathematics, almost costing the number one contendership match. And now the Cypher reciprocating with a chin lock, with a knee into the back of Lethal Mathematics. But now Lethal able to escape. And Lethal now with a drop kick catching the Cypher. Lethal now firing back with these strikes. Cypher now caught, and what a German suplex there. And you see the way he held onto him as he dropped him on the top of his head, trying to compress that spine and neck, trying to help him take the Cypher down here. And oh, went for that body splash and he missed it. And the Cypher, there's a beautiful Superman punch by the Cypher. Hook of the leg here now on Lethal Mathematics. Two, and oh my goodness. The Cypher thought he had that one right there and then. And this crowd chanted both these guys. What an opening matchup this is here tonight on MPWF Annihilation. The Cypher now waiting for Lethal Mathematics to get to his feet, but Lethal blocking that shot. And Lethal now right back to that Northern Light suplex. Popping those hips. Lethal Mathematics very good at Greco-Roman wrestling in his high school days. And now the Cypher, oh goodness. Not as technical as Lethal, but may be a tougher fighter. But it doesn't matter if you have your shoulder thrown into the steel ring post. There's a drop kick there by Lethal. And now Lethal here. Look at that beautiful high crotch. Floating around into the front face lock. And then getting back up again. Picture perfect wrestling. And now wait a minute here. This is the move. The Boston Crab. The Walls of Jericho. You can take it the way you see it. Have it the way you want it. The Cypher refused to submit to and passed out from the pain at Bloodlines. And Lethal though, too close to the ropes. Cypher able to grab them. And oh, what a chop there by Lethal. And look at these strikes trying to take this kid down, but the Cypher fighting back. And here comes that Queens New York style here as he finishes up with a boot to Lethal. And where's the Cypher going for here? The Cypher now, waiting for Lethal to get up, and the Cypher springboard elbow right to the spine of Lethal Mathematics. And now he's got Lethal up here. And now Lethal, oh my goodness, thrown right into that discus punch. And now the Cypher, what is he thinking about? Springboard here, oh my god! A springboard double footstop by the Cypher to Lethal Mathematics, and Lethal just gets the shoulder up. The Cypher is innovating his offense every time he's in the ring. He is pulling out all the stops to make it to SummerSlam. What a matchup this is here. And now wait a minute, Lethal's got him up with that gorilla press, and oh my goodness. A gorilla press into the Michinoku driver, but the Cypher with his foot under the ropes. And Lethal though, gonna drag him away from it. Is Lethal gonna go for the cover? Yes he is. Yes he is, to finish the Cypher here. Two, and oh, the Cypher gets the shoulder up. Both of these men trying to figure out what they have to do, how they're supposed to beat the other man here. And now Lethal firing at the Cypher. And now wait a minute. No, oh, face first to the turnbuckle. Goes the Cypher, but no, wait a minute. The Cypher fight back out here. The Cypher won't quit here, ladies and gentlemen. The Cypher won't quit. And now wait a minute. He's got Lethal Mathematics up here. Go for that top rope superplex, and he hits it. Beautiful, off the top rope. Cypher slowly getting to his feet. Lethal Mathematics down. The Cypher on the top rope now. And what is he signaling for here? And the Cypher, oh, went for the elbow, but Lethal moved out the way. And now, big time favor through there by Lethal Mathematics. And Lethal may have it off that high angle famouser to the Cypher. And oh, another near fall. Back and forth, folks. Birmingham is getting one hell of a show here already. And oh, wait a minute, right to that spy buster goes the Cypher. What's the Cypher signaling for here? The Cypher now. Oh, he may be looking for that 450 splash. He may be looking at that 450 splash. And the Cypher hits it off the top rope. The Cypher going to SummerSlam. He's going to SummerSlam. A yes or no? And now the Cypher getting frustrated. The Cypher getting frustrated. This crowd loving it. Lethal Mathematics kicking out the 450 splash. The Cypher now. Block shot there by Lethal. And there's a headbutt. He has to stay composed as the Cypher. Lethal now on the top rope. But Lethal with a crossbody. Crossbody off the top rope there by Lethal Mathematics. And now Lethal on the top. Cypher is down. And Lethal signaling for the end. And Lethal Mathematics shooting star press. Shooting star press. And Lethal Mathematics is going to SummerSlam to compete for the MPWF World Championship. What a match, folks. folks, that is how we're kicking the night off. That is how we're kicking this night off here with KK Kwam's MPWF Annihilation. What a wrestling match. And Lethal Mathematics has wrestled his way to the MPWF Championship matchup at SummerSlam. The question now is, who will his opponent be? Ryan Sparks or Benson Clement? But again, folks, let me give kudos to the Cypher. He will be a world champion on this roster, I promise you that. He is so close to reaching that next level. He took Lethal Mathematics to his limit here on Annihilation. What an awesome way to start this show off. And now wait a minute, folks. Harry Prince getting in the ring here to interview Lethal Mathematics for becoming the number one contender. And Prince says, Lethal, that match was insane. Congratulations on defeating the Cypher to become the number one contender for the MPWF Championship. You could either face Ryan Sparks or Benson Clement. Who would you prefer to face? Questions here for the new number one contender, Lethal Mathematics. Lethal says, you know, it's been a long time since I've had a shot at the MPWF title. The Cypher brought the fight, and one day he's going to main event in the MPWF, but today is not that day. My time is still now here in the MPWF, and it's time for me to be champion. Lethal Mathematics is ready to hold the MPWF title once again. Lethal says, me and Ryan have become friends, but we still need to find out who is better. And someone needs to take out Benson Clement before the darkness gets rolling on Annihilation. So I'll say it doesn't matter to me who I face on a professional level. Lethal is down to face either man, folks, either man. So this crowd here just wants to see Lethal challenge for the title. That's what they're here for. That's what they want to see. Lethal says, at SummerSlam, I will take back my name as Mr. MPWF. With that said, I will have Ryan's back tonight if Carnage or Sick Nick get involved in the main event. But mark my words, I will be MPWF champion at SummerSlam. Well, folks, Lethal Mathematics will have that opportunity. He will be challenging for the MPWF World Championship. But the question is, who? Who will be the MPWF champion by the time this show is all said and done? Welcome back to Annihilation, folks. The action is going to continue to roll here as we go right into a championship match. Again, congratulations to Lethal Mathematics on becoming the number one contender, as well as kudos to the Cypher. Like I said, the future is bright for that kid here in the MPWF. But here comes a hardcore icon, Billy Ray Peterson. Billy Ray Peterson, my guy, my man, needs a win big time here. KK Kwam has hooked him up with a shot at the Hardcore Championship. It feels like it's been a while since Billy Ray Peterson has had his hand raised in the MPWF, and we don't want that to be. We absolutely love BRP. We want BRP to succeed in the MPWF. But the ball is in his court. This is his style of matchup. A former Hardcore Champion, Billy Ray Peterson needs to do whatever he can to walk away tonight with that championship gold. MPWF Hardcore Champion, the Avenger, a man who has a new lease on life after the announcement that was made on episode 1. The Avenger, welcome to YouTube show, lost the opportunity to challenge for the MPWF World Title as long as Ryan Sparks held the belt. KK Kwam lifted that. The Avenger got down to the final two of the Rumble matchup where he was eliminated by the Cypher. But within saying that, he may not be challenging for the MPWF title at SummerSlam, but it is in the Avenger's future. He might be able to win that title at some point, a belt that has eluded him here in his MPWF career. Currently, he is the MPWF Hardcore Champion and has a hell of a fight coming up next against BRP. We got ourselves a fight here between two big boys for the Hardcore Championship. KK Kwam lifted the 24-7 rule, meaning the title can only be defended in regular singles matches or any other stipulations that KK Kwam allows it to. Again, with it being the Hardcore title, there are Hardcore rules, which means anything goes. Pinfalls and submissions count anywhere. I've said it, this is one of the hardest titles to hold on to, because of the nature of how violent these matches can be. And I expect no different in this matchup between BRP and the Avenger. They actually respect each other, that's why this matchup might be violent, because they're gonna beat the living hell out of each other to walk away with that right there, the Hardcore title. See the focus on Billy Ray Peterson's face, the bell to be sounded, and here we go. We are underway here, and look at that. Billy Ray Peterson and the Avenger staring down with each other. Billy Ray Peterson won the Hardcore Championship at the Bloodlines pre-show against Christian Paul, and then was screwed over by Kane Knight and has been failing ever since then. And like we mentioned, he needs a victory, and this would be huge here. Same as the Avenger. The Avenger was gifted the opportunity to challenge for the MPWF title once again. What he doesn't want to happen is start losing matches once that opportunity has been had. The Avenger is one of the top contenders for the MPWF World title here on Annihilation. Oh, Billy Ray Peterson moving out the way, and oh my goodness, Savant kick there. And these two men being wise here, starting this matchup out slow. They will get to bringing in the weapons and the violence in due time. So look at that, BRP choking out the Avenger here. And now Billy Ray Peterson got the Avenger throwing him to the outside of the ring. The Avenger falls to the outside here. Again, what a matchup we just saw leading to MPWF SummerSlam. MPWF War has provided us with the main event for SummerSlam, which will be a Hell in a Cell matchup. Shawn Stevens' career is on the line. He will challenge Max Payne for the Core World Championship. We tonight will find out who will be competing against Lethal Mathematics for the MPWF World Championship. We'll also find out the Women's Tag Team title finals that will take place at SummerSlam. You know, we didn't mention this earlier, but still to come tonight, a WrestleMania rematch. It'll be Justice Fitzgerald versus Angelina Peace. If Angelina Peace wins, she is added to the Undisputed title matchup at SummerSlam. Again, a lot going on here in the MPWF as the Avenger has Billy Ray Peterson up here. And now, oh my goodness! The Avenger just rolled Billy Ray Peterson up to the steel steps here. Already getting violent. And now, wait a minute, look at that there by the Avenger. The big man, the former Fight Japan Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion and leader of the Black Sun. He's the reason that Kane, Knight, and B.O.B. are in the MPWF as well. The Avenger pulling out all the stops here too on Annihilation. Wait, Billy Ray Peterson stopping him though. And oh my goodness, sending him to the barricade. Now, oh my god, the Avenger goes spine first. And now what's BRP looking for? Oh my god, he's got a shovel. No, the Avenger, I don't want no part of that. All right, BRP able to move out the way. Look at that chop. And Billy Ray Peterson, what a big clothesline. Dropping the Avenger. And now, oh my goodness. And that's where the hardcore rules come into action. And Billy Ray Peterson not playing around. Going for the cover here. After he knocked the Avenger down, but I'll kick out. You cannot play games, folks. You cannot play games. And now Billy Ray Peterson throwing the Avenger back inside the ring here. And now going right back to that shovel once again. And now BRP swinging. I know he hits this time. And now looking back underneath the ring, Billy Ray Peterson looking for more furniture. He's not content with what he has. And wait a minute, the Avenger has the shovel. The Avenger catches Billy Ray Peterson. But Peterson fights back here. This match is devolving between these two men. And now BRP. Oh my goodness, going after the arm there of the Avenger. So a little bit of a slower pace, hardcore title match than what we've seen before. Both of these men trying to feel each other out here. And what a gut buster there by Billy Ray Peterson. Now looking to hook the leg to get the cover here on the Avenger. One, two, and it'll kick out. So you notice Billy Ray Peterson is going for covers when he can. Like I said, he needs this win here on Annihilation. And BRP now. Oh my gosh, what a running punch. Maybe a running slap. You can take it out the way you see, have it the way you want it. And now, wait a minute. The Avenger fights back, though. On a forearm to the face. And now catching Billy Ray Peterson. And now, the Avenger. Oh my god. It takes a lot of power to do that to a man the size of BRP. And I'll kick you out. The Avenger now has BRP up. You see them tripping over these weapons here. Oh my god, what a knee to the face. And now, what a net breaker there by the Avenger. Dropping BRP. And apparently the Avenger is not done with the weaponry yet. And now he's pulled out a hockey stick here, folks. A hockey stick. And now the Avenger. Oh wait. BRP saw it coming and reverses it. And oh my goodness. But the Avenger doesn't drop, but he drops off that one. And now wait a minute. Billy Ray Peterson headed to the top rope. The Avenger down. BRP to go high risk here to become the new hardcore champion. And there's a moonsault off the top rope there by Billy Ray Peterson. Hook of the leg. Two. And oh my god, the Avenger gets the shoulder up. And Billy Ray Peterson cannot believe it. He cannot believe it. And now he's saying, it's all right. It's all good. I'll finish him now. I'll finish him here and now. And oh, code breaker there by Billy Ray Peterson. And now he's signaling for him to get back up again. Billy Ray Peterson has something big in mind for the Avenger. And he's got that hockey stick. And oh, wait, this time the Avenger reverses it. Oh my goodness, right to the spine, and another one. Oh, swinging for the fences, and he hits this time. And now the Avenger has that steel chair in hand. Billy Ray Peterson is out, folks. Oh no, wait, the Avenger telling this crowd it's over. A bit of a mixed reaction here for the Avenger tonight. The Avenger now, oh my gosh. BRP still standing, but not after that one. And the Avenger likes to use that power bomb or bicycle kick. And he's got the chair, and oh my god. And Peterson slowly getting to his feet. The Avenger has him up here. And the Avenger with a power bomb to Billy Ray Peterson. 2 and 3, and the Avenger retains the hardcore title. It's not a pretty championship, folks. It is a vicious war to become the hardcore champion. We've been seeing this title been defended in various promotions for over 30 years here in wrestling. And these two men beat the hell out of each other here tonight. But it's going to take a monumental effort from someone here on the Annihilation brand to take that title from the Avenger. Like I said, his momentum continues to build, especially with that, knowing that he could challenge at some point for the MPWF World Championship. The hardcore title is going to do wonders for him in the meantime before he can get to that world title, folks. But again, congratulations to the Avenger for winning here tonight. And this crowd here loving the Blackstone Cherry, loving the Avenger, cheering for a big time here tonight. Like I said, still to come, women's tag team match. Wait a minute, that's T-Dot from the World Wrestling Future attacking the Avenger. On our previous episode of the World Wrestling Future, it was announced that Lamar Goldman had been brought up to MPWF War and T-Dot to Annihilation, and T-Dot taking out the hardcore champion, the Avenger. Oh, there's a powerbomb. T-Dot showing up here and taking out the hardcore champion. T-Dot has been a menace in the World Wrestling Future and now here on the main roster for the first time. And now T-Dot has the Avenger up here. And now Muscle Buster dropping the Avenger down. T-Dot making a statement here on Annihilation and picking up that MPWF Hardcore Championship. We said it might take someone with a monumental effort to take out the Avenger. It might be that man right there. Look at this destruction laid out by T-Dot. The destroyer of the World Wrestling Future, now perhaps a destroyer of the MPWF. And T-Dot making the referee hand him the Hardcore Championship. Business just picked up. The landscape here at Annihilation has just changed with that man right there, the destroyer, T-Dot. Welcome back to Annihilation. We're here with KK Kwam, who was speaking to the Cypher backstage. And Kwam saying to the Cypher, your special talent, getting that close to defeating Lethal Mathematics is no easy feat, especially with all the wrestling you've been doing in Japan with FJCW. They're very proud of your work, young man. And that's right, the Cypher has been off wrestling in Japan, defending that Eastern Championship, as well as being here in the MPWF. The Cypher says, all that is cool, but without disrespecting you or FJCW, I didn't get the job done. It's not me facing Ryan Sparks or Benson Clement for the MPWF Championship. The praise I get is great, but I can't seem to beat the legends. Hawkins of Bloodlines, Sean for the US title, and now Lethal tonight. Got a lot of frustration on that young man's mind. The Cypher definitely did try his best, but it wasn't enough here. Kwam says, do you think Sean Stevens or Lethal was challenging for the MPWF title after a year of being on the main roster? It will come. I'm going to test you because I think you could be the best. Next episode, you will defend the FJCW Eastern title against Richard Hawkins. A bit of retribution there for the Cypher, but a massive match for him against Richard Hawkins. And the Cypher knows how big of a matchup that is on episode 3 of Annihilation. We will see how well you've improved since MPWF Bloodlines. If you can defeat Richard Hawkins, I'll have a special match for you at MPWF SummerSlam. You're on the cusp. Now is the time to push yourself. KK Kwam has plans for the Cypher. We just have to see if the Cypher can pull through. And a massive match on the next episode of Annihilation against Richard Hawkins. And here we go, folks. It is time now for the final semi-final matchup of the MPWF Women's Tag Team Championship Tournament. Introducing first here, Thrash and Bash, a team formerly known as Onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia won their debut matchup against the ATL, moving to the semi-finals. And here they compete tonight for the first time on Annihilation, with an opportunity to make it to SummerSlam and be in the finals and challenge for the women's tag team titles. Currently, we know the Legacy have made it to the finals after facing the Carmichaels in one of the best women's tag team matches we have ever seen in the MPWF. Onomatopoeia looks to make history, not only at SummerSlam, but tonight. Could they go undefeated in this tournament and become the women's tag team champions at SummerSlam? It won't be easy though, because this team of Destruction, Franse, Faye Bartlett, and Joan DuPont have a lot of momentum rolling into this tournament. Faye Bartlett coming off a win against Yoshihari Atari at WrestleMania. Not to mention their rivals have made it to the finals. Destruction Franse want to go ahead and make this as predictable as possible and get to face Atari and Sasha Fierce in the finals at SummerSlam. Look at Joan DuPont with her Bull Nakano vibes. Faye Bartlett, one of the best women's wrestlers we've ever had in the Major Pain Wrestling Federation. This is a phenomenal team. What this team definitely cannot do is underestimate Onomatopoeia. Because like I said, they beat the ATL in their debut, so everyone needs to stay focused here. A lot is riding on the line in this matchup. So we've already had what a crazy night of MPWF Annihilation. Still so much to come. The main event, Ryan Sparks versus Benson Clement for the MPWF Championship. As well as we have the contract signing for Ultimate Honor between Angel Ortiz and Ivan Volkov. But again, the women to continue here. Not to mention the fact that it would be Justice Fitzgerald versus Angelina Peace in a WrestleMania rematch. With the winner, if Angelina Peace wins, she will be added to the Undisputed Championship matchup at SummerSlam 2. A lot riding here on MPWF Annihilation. So here we go. We are underway here with this semifinals matchup. As Bash going right after Faye Bartlett here. And Onomatopoeia has a lot to prove in this matchup. A lot to prove to the MPWF fans. Again, the fans not as familiar with them as everyone else in this division. They could bring themselves to the very top of the start of the women's tag team division here in the MPWF. As they have her up now. And now look at this here, reverse suplex there, double team style. Thrash getting in the ring here. We've mentioned before how both these women from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, bringing that Canadian flavor to MPWF Annihilation tonight, but a part of the MPWF War roster. The women's tag team titles are dual branded. They could be defended on both shows, ladies and gentlemen. Now, wait a minute here. As Faye Bartlett, and oh, what a shot to the leg there. And another one. Thrash here working and wearing down Faye Bartlett. And once again, congratulations to the Avenger but for retaining the hardcore title. But T-Dot making his debut before the break, taking the Avenger out. We also found out the announcement that the Cypher will defend the FJCW Eastern Championship against one Richard Hawkins on our next episode. The action always continues here in the MPWF. As Faye now makes the tag, Joan DuPont getting inside the ring here. Now, oh my gosh. Face first into the double boot. And Joan DuPont also brand new, but under the tutelage of Faye Bartlett, picked out of the French independent scene by Faye. And she was very impressive in their first matchup. There's a nice reverse out back elbow. And knocking her thrash off the apron, and DuPont in complete control of this matchup. So did you know that Yushahari Atari and Sasha Fierce are back home watching these matches very intensely to see who they would meet in the finals? We know they want Destruction France in the finals, but it would be an interesting matchup against Onomatopoeia as well. Center into the ropes here, nice double team move there. And Faye Bartlett straight into the cover here, looking to finish it off here, two, and a kick out. Crowd here in Alabama cheering for the Canadians over the French women. And oh my goodness, what a boot to the face there. And Faye Bartlett is milking and drinking in this crowd's rage against her right now. Now wait a minute here, Bash fighting back. Bash needs to make a tag to her cousin. Whips her into the buckle. Elbow right to the face. I know, oh, went for the elbow but missed. But this time with a quick right hand. But no, Bash fights back. Bash firing back against Faye Bartlett. And there's a headbutt. And now wait, trying to get Faye. And oh, Faye fires back with an elbow to the midsection. Faye Bartlett now. Again, quickly cutting that ring in half. Bringing Bash to her side. Not allowing her to make the tag to Thrash here as DuPont gets back inside the ring. And now look at this collar elbow tie-up. Has her up here. Now look at the power of Joan DuPont with that fall-away slam. And DuPont is all fired up. But wait a minute. In the meantime, she makes the tag. And Thrash gets in. A nice, beautiful standing calf kick. And now going for another one. No. Clothesline sending DuPont to the outside of the ring. Thrashed out or stomp it on Faye Bartlett's foot. And now a drop kick. And she's got both of Destruction France on the outside. Now off the top rope, and there's an elbow to the floor. DuPont going back after Faye Bartlett now. And Thrashed out sending DuPont to the floor. And Thrashed out. What is she going for here? DuPont is spaghetti leg. Faye Bartlett getting to her feet. And now off the top rope, and oh my goodness, there's the molly go round. Off the top rope, taking out Joan DuPont, and Thrash has fired up here in this matchup. And now on knee to the face. Thrash is single-handedly taking out Destruction France here. And DuPont now heading to the top rope. And I think she's confused. I don't think she knows where she is right now. And look at these strikes here by Thrash, but oh, DuPont fires back. And DuPont off the top rope, but Thrash blocks it. The entire momentum of this matchup changed once Thrash got in the ring. And there was the pay dirt. Look at the leg here on Joan DuPont, two. And oh my goodness. Close call there for Thrash. Close call for Onomatopoeia. And now send her into the ropes. And oh wait, reversal there. Oh, there's the STO there by Joan DuPont. And now DuPont makes the tag to Bartlett. Bartlett back inside the ring here. And now, oh my gosh, what a face buster there. Faye Bartlett, a former MPWF Women's World Champion, with that outer crescent kick taking out Thrash, hooking a leg here, looking to go to the finals of this tournament, but oh, Thrash kicks out. So we have never had MPWF Women's Tag Team Champions, and that is going to change at SummerSlam, but there's a roll up, and oh, Faye Bartlett grabbing the ropes. The ring awareness of the veteran was incredible there, and our Bartlett fires back, and our Bartlett with a roll up this time, and she's got the tights here, but oh, reversal, and oh, wait a minute, Thrash, reversal here, 1, 2, and oh, kick out. Back and forth action in this tag team matchup. Faye Bartlett rolls out the way, and right back to that face buster again. Said, I don't know if Destruction Front, say, wanted the momentum to pick up the way it is. Having it slow and methodical was working great for them. And now, wait a minute, makes the tag, and in comes Bash. And what are they going for here? And a back stagger into the belly-to-belly suplex. What a move there. Bash now. Oh, trying to knock Joe DuPont off the apron. And there's a drop kick. She needs to make the cover now with Faye Bartlett. But was it too much time? Was it too much time? 1, 2. Oh, my goodness gracious me. Faye Bartlett just got the shoulder up. Bash now, looking to end this one right here and now. All right, big kick to the gut. What's she going for here? And there's a neck breaker. And you see the Faye Bartlett grabbing her neck immediately. Bash now up the top rope, gonna go high risk on Faye Bartlett. Faye Bartlett now in trouble. Oh, she moves out the way from the elbow drop. And now Bartlett sending Bash into the corner and makes a tag. And in comes DuPont. And now what are they going for here? Oh, wait a minute. She's got her up here to pile driver. Right now. Oh, no! Spike pile driver. Spike pile driver. And DuPont now slashing Thrash right into the ring. What a vicious spike pile driver. DuPont with the cover. And Destruction Front say make it to the finals. The pace picked up for that matchup when Thrash came in off the tag to save her teammate. But a spike pile driver sends Destruction Front say to the finals. So you gotta feel bad for Onomatopoeia. That backstabber into the belly-to-belly suplex. Bash took a little too much time. I think if she was able to get that cover right away, they would be going to the finals, but there you have it. Destruction Front say pulling out the win here tonight. And look at the confidence in their eyes. What a vicious pile driver by those two. The crowd might not like it, but what a matchup. And again, congratulations to them. Wait a minute, here, Clarissa Clearwater to interview Destruction Fraud Say. She says, ladies, I just want to grab a quick word with you. Congrats on making it to the finals at SummerSlam. It's already shaping up to be a great event, and you both will battle your rivals Sasha Fierce and Yoshihari Itari. What do you have to say about that? It's going to be a battle for the Women's Tag Team Championships. Man, this crowd ain't giving them a chance here. Faye Bartlett says, this is perfect. Some of you may call it predictable, but we are the four best women's wrestlers in this tournament. Defeating Yoshihari Itari is what I thought I needed to push myself to the next level, but no, I needed more, and at SummerSlam, I am going to get it. And that they will. Destruction Francais versus the Legacy. She says Itari was once great, but she gave up what made her unique. She lost her edge, and I beat her at WrestleMania. I promised to finish her and I broke that promise thanks to another legend, Sasha Fierce. Now we'll have them both in the ring at the same time. Well, I mean, it's not going to be a one-sided thing like you guys think. against Atari and Fierce at SummerSlam. She says they would be so close to making history, to adding to their beautiful resumes, and then boom, we snatch it from them and become the first ever MPWF Women's Tag Team Champions. She is, again, she's even speaking French right now, folks. She says that they are the game changers of the women's tag team division. And again, it is hard to argue with Destruction Francais. And she says, and let's not forget about Joan DuPont, the future of the MPWF Women's Division. This monster will destroy two legends at SummerSlam, and then I've promised Joan that she could cut both their hair off. SummerSlam will be our night. So they said not only are they win the tag team titles, they're going to cut both of Yushahari Atari and Sasha Fierce's hair at SummerSlam. It's going to be a wild matchup for the women's tag team titles. Welcome back, folks. We're here with Harry Prince, who was found T-Dot backstage. And Harry Prince says, welcome back to Annihilation. At this time, I'm here with you, Annihilation wrestler T-Dot. T-Dot, I think we would like an explanation as to why you have targeted the Avenger and the MPWF Hardcore title. T-Dot says, it's a simple. The last episode, Kwam wasted his time lifting the Avengers ban on the MPWF title. He is past his prime. He needs to get out the line altogether. He's washed up like the Hardcore title is washed up. And T-Dot clearly not happy about the Hardcore division here on Annihilation. He said, what year is it, Harry? 1997, 2001. The Hardcore division is outdated. I want to create something new. I am 2023. I am the now. It doesn't matter if you're a cruiserweight, a heavyweight, hardcore, high flyer. I want zero limits. I don't know what T-Dot means by that. Zero limits. Yeah. Zero limits sounds good, says T-Dot. Avenger, I'm coming for you and your title. I'm making it mine. And Billy Ray Peterson, go back to a Bingo Horror Legion and become a weekend warrior because you can't cut it anymore. T-Dot with some vicious words for both of these men here tonight. But T-Dot don't want no Hardcore division. He wants zero limits. Again, I'm not sure what that means, folks. But oh no, here it comes, man. The man with the longest name in all of core wrestling. The man with three first names. Beautiful Bobby Martin Kyle. And again, we are going to be here for a long time because Bobby Martin Kyle entrance takes a long time, folks. So as I like to do, I like to do our plugs in. Now, Court All-Stars 15 is coming up. Let's not forget that the MPWF will be competing. Team MPWF, Brian Adams and Carmen Carmichael will meet Team Madhouse, APAC, Aries, and Roxy Kush Hayes. Not to mention, we have MPWF SummerSlam coming up on Click Review. Follow us at MPWF 2013, as well as, folks, if you want to join the MPWF, if you want to submit your call, follow the instructions, go to our Twitter page and submit your call on using the hashtag MPWF Forever. I can't accept you to the MPWF if you guys don't submit. If you want your call to be on the MPWF, that is how you do it, folks. as well as follow us on Instagram as well at MPWF Forever. Remember to like it, subscribe, and MPWF Wrestling on YouTube. I don't know anything else, folks. You got 10 for 10 deals at Canadian Superstore if you live in Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, Beaumont Carr has still not made his way to the ring. He did have a very good showing in the Rumble matchup on our previous episode, but he is looking to make MPWF Annihilation his own. So here we go. You got James Wang Yang versus Bobby Martin Kyle. I look at Bobby Martin Kyle being cocky for no reason. And James Wang Yang now is going to look to take advantage of that situation. And now, wait a minute, what is he doing to beautiful Bobby Martin Kyle here? And now he's got him. And now he's going to throw him shoulder first into the steel ring post. And oh, there's a boot right to the face. And oh my goodness, James Wang Yang is firing up. Could you imagine if he beat Bobby Martin Kyle here tonight? And oh, wait a minute. Bobby Martin Kyle catching him and off, tripping him up. Now there's his chops and strikes there by beautiful Bobby Martin Kyle. And now he's whipping James Wang Yang into the ropes. And now look at this here, nice twisting net breaker. And oh, he could be looking for that beautiful DDT here. Kick to the gut. Beautiful Bobby Martin Kyle drives it face first. And that is all she wrote, folks. Off the cover. Oh my goodness. His entrance was longer than the match. His entrance was longer than the match, but if he hits you with that, folks, it is all said and done. The beautiful DDT by beautiful Bobby Martin Kyle. A momentum building win here for Bobby Martin Kyle on MPWF Annihilation. Oh, look at this backstage. Klaus has returned and he's reviving Volkov. And Klaus saying, sir, let me take him out. He put me on the shelf. You don't need to be in this match with him. You should be the MPWF champion. You should be facing Lethal at SummerSlam. I am ready. I can take Ortiz. I am better than him. This crowd here don't like Klaus at all Team Bloodshed. But again, we have a contract signing coming up later tonight. Ivan Volkov says, Klaus, you are my successor for Team Bloodshed, but you are not ready for Ortiz yet. When I had you debut before Bloodlines, I thought you were. It's close, but Ortiz is on another level right now, which is nothing against you. I don't know if Klaus is going to take it that way, though. Imagine telling someone like Klaus that he is not quite on Angel Ortiz's level. He said, Ortiz rejected my teachings, and at SummerSlam, I will make him tap and show him that I am right. You need to focus on those tag team titles and getting Shane up to your level. I want you to have a lengthy run with the belts. Show the world who Team Bloodshed is. And they very well might do that, folks. Still to come tonight, Team Bloodshed going to be in tag team action. And Klaus saying, what if Ortiz beats you at SummerSlam? What happens with Team Bloodshed? And that's a big question there, folks. Ivan says nothing will happen to Team Bloodshed. You will carry its legacy, and at SummerSlam, I will put it into execution. Tensions are rising high here on MPWF Annihilation. SummerSlam coming up ever so close. But as I mentioned before, still to come tonight, it's going to be tag team action for Team Bloodshed. But coming up next, a WrestleMania rematch. Justice Fitzgerald versus Angelina Peace. The difference this time, if Angelina Peace wins, she joins Ingrid and Justice Fitzgerald in a triple threat, undisputed title matchup at SummerSlam. And here comes the current MPWF Women's World Champion, Justice Fitzgerald. Those belts will be unified with the Intercontinental title at SummerSlam because both of the belts were drafted to Annihilation. Sasha Fierce. I just got old school Chandrella Johnson vibes is what I should say, but wait a minute. Here comes Angelina Peace. Angelina Peace is not waiting for Justice Fitzgerald here. Angelina Peace is going right after her. Folks, if you haven't checked out WrestleMania, once this show is done, go onto our YouTube channel and check it out. We are at 800 views for WrestleMania at this point, folks. It was a hell of a show. But Angelina Peace lost to Justice Fitzgerald. She went to show her respect, and Justice Fitzgerald attacked her, claiming herself as the mother of the MPWF Women's Division. The Justice has arrived, and now Angelina Peace arrived on our previous episode, and now looking to get retribution in this matchup. A WrestleMania rematch here on Annihilation. And all these two women are brawling around the ring. Justice Fitzgerald broke any kind of professional respect that these two women have for each other at WrestleMania. And Angelina Peace walking right into these chops by Justice Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald not even able to take off her jacket yet. And now, sending Angelina Peace into the buckle. Now look at this here. Justice Fitzgerald, one of the best women's wrestlers in the world. She has to be. She's the world champion. But she misses the knee drop off the top turnbuckle. And now, wait a minute. Beautiful fisherman suplex there by Angelina Peace. And Peace now, crucifix driver, dropping Justice right onto her neck. Angelina Peace with no care about Justice Fitzgerald's body whatsoever. And what's she going for here? And now, oh my goodness, Justice Fitzgerald went neck first into the ropes. And Angelina Peace is on fire here tonight, folks. On fire. Angelina Peace was the former women's champion and held that belt for over a year. And now look at this here. Go for an inverted figure four leg lock on Justice Fitzgerald. Looking to make her tap out. I said Justice Fitzgerald needs to win this matchup because it's bad enough having to fight Ingrid. She doesn't want to have to defend her title against both Angelina Peace and Ingrid. And I went for that drop kick. Peace moved out the way. Wait, block shot there. And now, oh my goodness. So it was an incredible matchup at WrestleMania. One of the best of the entire night between these two women. So Justice Fitzgerald bringing in Brooklyn Von Braun to the Major Pain Wrestling Federation. Not a very popular decision by any means. And Injustice has been trying to speak to her friend Serenity, but her arrogance is shown through, and I don't think it's worked as well. We still don't know how Justice feels about the fact that Serenity and Brooklyn Von Braun got eliminated in the quarterfinals for the Women's Tag Team Title Tournament. But Justice Fitzgerald, though, gonna go high risk here, and she dives on top of Angelina Peace. And again, regardless of how athletic she is, look at the arrogance of Justice Fitzgerald. That is what is becoming a problem. Winning the championship, winning the WrestleMania tournament, went straight to Justice Fitzgerald's head. Her ego, her head is inflated four times the size since those accolades. And oh man, slamming Angelina Peace on the table. And Angelina Peace would love to knock her down a peg or two. What a shot there by Justice. And this crowd here in Birmingham do not like Justice Fitzgerald at all. You can hear the vitriol from the crowd. There's a nice turning flapjack there by Fitzgerald. And Fitzgerald now hooking the leg here on Angelina Peace. Making sure it's more cinched in. Two and a kick out. And Justice was complaining before the show began. Why is she wrestling tonight and not Ingrid? But again, it's because of Justice Fitzgerald's actions on the previous episode. Assaulting Ingrid from behind. Assaulting Angelina Peace at WrestleMania. And now look at that strike there by Angelina Peace. Fighting back here. Peace now on the top rope. And oh wait, Justice trying to catch her. Peace stopped her. And Angelina Peace now. Whisper in the wind. Up the top. Taking out the women's champion. Hook of the leg. Does Angelina Peace. And oh, kick out. Kick to the midsection though. Angelina Peace as Goddard gonna go for that reverse net breaker. She hits it. Big time net breaker. Hooking the leg here on Justice Fitzgerald. Two. And oh, Fitzgerald gets the shoulder up. So this is definitely not as technically sound as their matchup at WrestleMania. These two women are trying to punish each other here. And oh, wait a minute. Double leg takedown. And now Justice Fitzgerald going for the figure four leg lock. And she cinched it in. And there it is. But a rope break immediately by Angelina Peace. And now, oh, wait a minute. That was a questionable shot there by Justice Fitzgerald. That one potentially may have been below the belt. And now, whipping Angelina Peace into the ropes. There's a nice back elbow taking out Angelina Peace. And Justice now has her up on her shoulders. Oh, wait, reversal. Oh, nice move there by Angelina Peace. Reversing Justice Fitzgerald. And now Peace heading to the top rope here. And Angelina Peace with a high angle leg drop. High angle leg drop. Hooking the cover. Two. And oh my goodness, near fall there. What a series of matches we have seen already here on Annihilation. We still have an MPWF World Title match with our main event, Benson Clement and Ryan Sparks. I will continue to advertise it because it's going to be a barn burner, ladies and gentlemen. But wait a minute now. And now, oh my goodness. Angelina Peace with the leg drop off the top rope to the outside of the ring. All she wants to do is punish Justice. But oh, wait a minute, Fitzgerald fights back though. Referee counted, trying to keep control of this matchup. And oh, what a big chop there. And now, natural selection right there on the floor by Justice Fitzgerald. And now Justice has Angelina Peace by the hair and throws her inside the ring. And yeah, that might be it. That was a hard landing. You heard that thud on the mat on the outside there. To get a kick out there by Angelina Peace. So, I said my voice is barely holding on, folks. Barely holding on. And now, oh, off the top rope, and she missed again. Going for that knee drop. Does Justice Fitzgerald. Oh, what a shot there. Maybe go for the net breaker. Does Angelina Peace. Nice reversal there by Justice. Fights back with the elbow. Float over. And a beautiful DDT that Shane McMahon would be proud of. And now Fitzgerald got her up. What a knife edge chop this is. Punishing Angelina Peace. And a clothesline knocking her right down to the mat. Justice trying to slow things down here. Reversal shot there by Angelina Peace. I want a forearm knocking Justice back down. But Justice, though, knocks Peace back off of her. So these two women are back and forth all the time. Reversal and another one knocking down Justice Fitzgerald. And Peace letting her get up this time. There's a drop kick. Reversal by Justice. And now a strike to Angelina Peace. And now Peace, though. Now Justice. Now Peace. Now Peace. Now Justice. Oh my goodness. And wait a minute. Block shot again. And now a block shot by Angelina Peace. And that one knocks out Justice Fitzgerald. What a strike exchange between these two women. And now Angelina Peace sending Justice into the buckle. And oh, wait a minute. This is not good for Justice Fitzgerald. Angelina Peace has her where she wants her. And now what is this? And now, oh my God. T-bone suplex off the top turnbuckle to Justice Fitzgerald. And Fitzgerald just gets the shoulder up, preserving the one-on-one match for SummerSlam. But this crowd loving this action. The WrestleMania rematch between Justice Fitzgerald and Angelina Peace. And now Angelina Peace firing up here. Justice Fitzgerald in trouble. And oh, she just used Justice Fitzgerald's finishing maneuver. The JKO on Justice Fitzgerald 2. And oh, again. Say what you want about Justice. She still manages to survive. What a match. Angelina Peace though ain't done. Angelina Peace looking for the end here. And oh wait, Justice moved out the way. And Justice now. Going for it on, there's the JKO, and that's it. Justice Fitzgerald hitting it flush. Two. Now Angelina Peace gets the shoulder up. Angelina Peace still in it. Ladies and gentlemen, this place is at a fever pitch right now. These two women battling for it. My God, I'm sorry. folks. They are going at it. As Justin sending Angelina piece to the outside the ring. Oh man, face first goes Angelina piece. And now, again, Justice taking her out. Folks, I am trying my best to keep up with this matchup. My voice is going as we speak. These two women are beating the brains out of each other. But right there is no need to be arrogant, as she might pay for it. No, wait a minute, what's this here? And oh my goodness, what a pump handle slam on the floor there by Angelina Peace. And Peace now got Justice not sending her face first into the announce table. Oh, this might be bad for Mrs. Fitzgerald. Justice is in trouble. Angelina Peace has got her up here. And now, oh my goodness, the rock bottom through the announce table. And Angelina Peace gonna let this count out happen. She could win. Oh no, she's not. She's going after Justice Fitzgerald. And oh, wait a minute, look at the stage. Brooklyn Von Braun appearing on the stage here. The new best friend of Justice Fitzgerald. And Angelina Peace now looking at the Titantron to see that Brooklyn Von Braun is there. Wait a minute! There's Ingrid! There's the machine, Ingrid! And Ingrid coming out of nowhere. And Ingrid now choking out Brooklyn Von Braun. Ingrid now, oh my goodness. The Coquina clutch as she has taken out Brooklyn Von Braun, so she cannot interrupt this match. And Von Braun is down. Ingrid saving Angelina Peace. Justice Fitzgerald still out. Angelina Peace waiting for her to get to her feet. And Peace now, JKO for the second time. Angelina Peace gonna pick Justice Fitzgerald with her own move. 2, 3, and Angelina Peace is going to SummerSlam. My goodness, folks. What a fight that was. What a fight that was. Brooklyn Von Braun tried to interrupt, but Ingrid having Angelina Peace's back. And Angelina Peace sending the ultimate message to Justice Fitzgerald. Angelina Peace beating Justice Fitzgerald with her JKO. And now we have a three-way dance for the Women's Undisputed Championship at SummerSlam. Wow. Wow, folks. That was hella good, I'll tell you that right now. Honestly, fam, they killed it. And oh, wait a minute! Ingrid just dropped Angelina Peace with the Intercontinental Championship. The hell is going on here? Ingrid just saved Angelina Peace, and now Ingrid's taking her out. And Ingrid has her Intercontinental Championship. Ingrid says, I just wanted to remind you, Angelina, and everyone else, I am in this three-way dance match. I am the Intercontinental Champion, and at SummerSlam, I will be the first Undisputed Women's Champion. I am the effing machine. I am Ingrid. Ingrid sending a message here, folks. A message. Ingrid said, bring him out, bring him out. She don't mind Angelina Peace being in this matchup, but she is the woman who is going to walk away as the Undisputed Champion. My God, folks, SummerSlam is going to be incredible. Welcome back to Annihilation. And now Ryan Sparks is with Richie Hawkins again. And Ryan saying, man, what do you want? I have a major title match to prepare for tonight. If you haven't heard, I'm facing Benson Clever for the MPWF title. If I have any hope of making it to SummerSlam to face Lethal. So whatever you want to say, you need to make it quick. Said Hawkins has been in the ear of Ryan Sparks for a long time now. Richard Hawkins said, easy, Tiger. I'm telling you everything you need to know. I can help you stop Benson Clever tonight. You'll need your back watch while he has systematic carnage and sick Nick on his side. Let me take you to the next level as champion. Tell you this, persistence is key. Richard Hawkins wants to do whatever he can to get Ryan Sparks on his side. Ryan says again, what champion would I be if I cheated to beat Benson Clement? I beat Ivan Volkov and Angel Ortiz in the same night to become the MPWF World Champion. I beat you last episode. I am already ready. I already know what I need to do. That's right, Ryan Sparks, main event Ryan Sparks has unleashed the animal inside and has become the MPWF World Champion. Hawkins says, so, say you get past Clement tonight. What about your partner Lethal? You don't think he's going to stab you in the back? You can feel the arrogance oozing off him tonight. Mr. MPWF is coming back. Mr. MPWF broke your arm. Remember that. Again, they had quite the war in 2021, did Lethal and Ryan Sparks. We are 2 years ahead of that. Hawkins says, you won in the main event of WrestleMania, yet all the promotion for SummerSlam is for Max Payne and Shawn Stevens. Everyone is excited about Ultimate Honor, yet they don't speak your name. If you don't listen to me, at least listen to the whispers. Your main event, Ryan Sparks, not mid-card Ryan. Richard Hawkins trying a different tactic here. Maybe getting under the skin of Ryan Sparks. And this is not good, as Ryan has to compete later tonight against Benson Clement for the MPWF Championship. We get ready here for tag team action on MPWF Annihilation. Again, remember to like the video and subscribe. Tell everyone about it. The MPWF is back and it has been strong since the ending of 2020. WrestleMania was incredible. We're on the road to SummerSlam and everybody is trying to fight with everything they got to find their positioning on the card. So this should be a hell of a tag team here. Both men former tag team champions in their own right. Scorpion Zinder a part of Gen X back in the day, and John Smith a part of the Varsity Club, excuse me there. I was drinking at the same time whilst I was speaking. Sorry, the Varsity Club, one of the best tag teams the MPWF has ever seen. In fact, they were the former tag team champions. Team Bloodshed defeated them at the WrestleMania buy-in show. So this matchup is also quite special for John Smith. Never getting a rematch for the tag team titles because Cass Michaels was drafted to MPWF War. He has a chance to get some retribution against Team Bloodshed in this tag team match tonight. And there they are, the impressive MPWF World Tag Team Champions, Shay Riley and Klaus, representing Team Bloodshed. Again, a spectacular match in the main event of the WrestleMania buy-in show that saw these two men become the tag team champions. They were able to escape the MPWF draft against the Future Foundation with the tag team title belts. And you heard it earlier, Ivan Volkov wants these two men to focus on those tag team titles, to continue to improve in the ring. Meanwhile, he himself will deal with Angel Ortiz in their Ultimate Honor match. A big question here is, who is going to challenge Team Bloodshed for the tag team titles? Well, we know there's the young ones who won on the previous episode to beat the Commonwealth that would love a shot at the tag team titles. The Commonwealth is there, a more than formidable tag team with John Smith and Scorpion Zinder. We could be building a huge tag team division here on MPWF Annihilation. But again, it's not going to be easy to dethrone this team right here. here we go. Scorpion Zinder starting things off with Shane Riley. And again, Scorpion Zinder here on Annihilation by himself to prove how good he is, but he is failing right now, folks. I was about to put Scorpion Zinder over, be getting caught by them kicks by Shane Riley, but he fights back here. And now brings in John Smith, and like we said, John Smith has a lot of history of Team Bloodshed in both incarnations. The Varsity Club battled with this version with Klaus and Shane Riley, as well as the version with Rhino Rick Jones back in 2021. So, you know, they know each other very well here. Nice snap suplex there by John Smith. So the Varsity Club trying to find their footing, becoming singles wrestlers for the first time. A lot of boot there, but Shane moved out the way. A nice chop block taking out John Smith here. And that's what everybody has to worry about. This man right here who just made the tag, the big man Klaus. But John Smith showing no fear here. Look at these shots there by Klaus. He is a monster. So we heard it earlier. Ivan Volkov wants him to carry the legacy of Team Bloodshed as he pictured it. Angel Ortiz had his own ideals. Volkov believes that Klaus is that man, the Scorpion of Team Bloodshed. Now wait a minute here, Klaus sending John Smith into the buckle. And now makes the tag, and Shane Riley back in the ring here. And now what is this they're going for? He's got him held up, suspended in the air, and now going right after the back and the kidneys to Shane Riley. And there's a kick to the spine. Shane Riley though, checking his neck out, applying himself back to this matchup. But oh, John Smith fights back. And John Smith now making, whipping him into the buckle to make the tag to Scorpion Zinder. And again, what a whirlwind of events we saw before the break here. Angelina Peace added to the three-way dance match for the Undisputed Women's Championship. What a battle that's going to be at SummerSlam. Ingrid versus Angelina Peace versus Justice Fitzgerald. Oh man, Zinder went for that springboard, but Shane Riley moved out the way. And what a knee strike there by Shane Riley. Shane Riley wanting to prove to not just Ivan Volkov, but the world, that he is not the weak link of Team Bloodshed. And that's exactly how you do that, with that knee to the face. Again, still to come, the contract signing between Ivan Volkov and Angel Ortiz. The MPWF Championship match. And now, wait a minute. He's got Scorpion Zinder up here. What a kick. It is a brain buster. Team Bloodshed dominating right now. Shane Riley trying to help John Smith off the apron. Two, John Smith is there. And oh, my goodness. Zinder needs to fight back here. He is in trouble. Now look at that. Going right after the arm does Klaus. And Klaus now has Zinder up. And now Zinder off face first into the top turnbuckle. And now beautiful body slam there by Klaus. Like I said, again, we talk about the future. And because the talent is so strong in the MPWF, that's why we're like, this guy's the future. This guy's the future. But again, Klaus defeated Angel Ortiz in his debut matchup. You know, shenanigans or not, that is no easy feat. Klaus, the sky is the limit for him. And Team Bloodshed continues to dominate in this tag team matchup. Scorpion Zinder and John Smith need to do something, and something quick here. Oh, look at that beautiful double leg takedown. Switching past the leg, going up to the guard position and switching there to the arm breaker or the arm bar. You take it the way you see it, have it the way you want it. As Shane Riley wrenching on Scorpion Zinder here. But Zinder though, reversing, escaping and fighting out here. Zinder needs to make the tag to John Smith. And oh wait, block shot there by Shane Riley. And now look at this here again. Oh my goodness, look at these strikes here. Scorpion Zinder is bleeding. He's getting outstruck here by Shane Riley. Team Bloodshed are menaces here. And now wait a minute. Scorpion Zinder makes the tag. John Smith now in the ring. And John Smith jumping up with that Hurricane Rana. And now, oh my goodness, rolling wheel kick there by John Smith. And Smith now trying to build the momentum back to his team here. And now wait a minute, whipping him into the ropes. Ducking underneath them. Shane Riley hangs on. John Smith saw it coming. And now, oh, what a German suplex there by John Smith. Using those NCAA hips. And John Smith now going after Klaus again. There's no fear by John Smith. Shane Riley in trouble. And Smith now, look at this. Nice takedown. And there's a reverse Boston Crab by John Smith. As he's applying the pressure. What, I mean, reverse Boston, would that be a Mississippi Crab? You guys got to tell me more about American geography. And wait a minute, Shane Riley though, fights back here. Look at these strikes. His Muay Thai is second to none here in the MPWF. And oh, wait a minute, Smith though fires back. Shane Riley though, falling into his corner. John Smith in the wrong part of town as he's firing back up on Shane Riley. And what a European uppercut. And I go for the ankle lock. John Smith go for the ankle lock, but Shane Riley gets the ropes. And John Smith firing up this crowd, changing the entire outset of this match. Oh wait, reversal there by Shane Riley. Oh my God! What a boot to the face there by Shane Riley. A front snap kick, if you will, taking him down. And now in comes Klaus. And now wait, oh, DDT here. And now pushing him, and there's a wheelbarrow German suplex. What a boot to John Smith. And now wait a minute, Smith firing back though. And now, oh my goodness! Klaus just ran up and double drop kicked that man. Said this is Sparta right to the chest. And so that short arm clothesline knocked John Smith loopy. And now look at this here, Klaus pounding away at the chest of Scorpion Zinder. My God, how many times is he going to beat him down? Oh my Lord. Klaus is a one-man army, folks. He is a one-man army. And here it is. This vicious powerbomb by Klaus is going to end this one right here and now. Oh my goodness. And that is it. Two. And oh, Scorpion Zinder broke it up. Scorpion Zinder broke it up. Oh no, wait a minute, Klaus though has Scorpion Zinder up. Oh my goodness. And covering him anyways. Covering him anyways. And it didn't even matter. It didn't even matter. Once Klaus hits you with that powerbomb, when you land on your neck and upper spine, that is all she wrote. Full spinal compression by Klaus there. What a dominant performance by the MPWF World Tag Team Champions, Team Bloodshed. Like I said, it's not going to be an easy task for whichever team tries to take the tag team titles from Team Bloodshed. Especially with that man Klaus on that team. He is a dangerous, dangerous human being. Oh, wait a minute. That's the music of the young ones. That's the music of the young ones. And there they are, Christian Paul and Young Mike, getting another huge ovation from this crowd here in Annihilation. And now wait a minute, they're grabbing microphones here, folks. The young ones have something they want to say. And Christian Paul saying, we're going to make this short and sweet. Team Bloodshed, we want a shot at the MPWF Tag Team Championships at SummerSlam. You already know our credentials. Let us prove that we are ready to win the MPWF Tag Team titles. The young ones making the challenge. And what will be their answer? Shane Riley says, we accept. at SummerSlam. It's going to be the Young Ones versus Team Bloodshed for the MPWF World Tag Team Championships. Man, this is shaping up to be an all-time event, is MPWF SummerSlam. What a tag team title matchup that's going to be. The Young Ones versus Team Bloodshed. Oh, wait a minute. Benson Clement backstage saying, what is a king without a crown? What is a god without his followers? What is the Lord of Darkness without the MPWF Championship? He is incomplete. I am incomplete. At WrestleMania, I finish Helios Christ. I need my crown. He says, Ryan, you have heard this a lot, but tonight your fairy tale ends. The void is calling. It is hungry for the MPWF title. I will make it quick and easy for you tonight. None shall stand in my way again. Carnage and Sicknick now abide by the void's rules, and we will execute them on Ryan Sparks tonight and Lethal Mathematics at SummerSlam. All shall be sucked into the void. Well, folks, our main event tonight, Ryan Sparks versus Benson Clement for the MPWF Championship. And again, folks, remember to follow us at MPWF 2013 on Twitter. What a main event we have scheduled. Folks, coming up next is going to be the contract signing for the MPWF Ultimate Honor matchup. And again, remember to follow us on Instagram at MPWF Forever, ladies and gentlemen. That's where you can get all the MPWF updates. But here we go. What an ovation for Sub-Zero, Angel, Ramirez, Ortiz. This man has been waiting for so long for this opportunity to get Ivan Volkov one-on-one. And at SummerSlam, it will finally happen. Ultimate honor. No one will interfere. Anything goes. The only rule is submission. Someone will tap out. Will it be Ivan Volkov or Angel Ortiz? That is what we're going to find out at SummerSlam. These men are allowed nowhere near the MPWF Championship until this issue between the two of them is sorted out. Look at the intensity in the eyes of Angel Ortiz as we get set for this amazing contract signing. And that said as well, once the contract is signed, these men will not be able to lay a finger on each other until MPWF SummerSlam. Just saw the student make his way to the ring. Here comes the master, the Russian badass, Ivan Volkov. He went undefeated in core wrestling for over 10 years, the former MPWF World's Heavyweight Champion. Ivan Volkov wants to get back to that championship belt that is currently held by Ryan Sparks. But again, he must enter into this matchup at SummerSlam and tap out his student. The intensity between both of these men is off the charts. Like I said, I cannot wait for MPWF SummerSlam, ladies and gentlemen. It is going to be an incredible quick review, and you need to be here for this show. Hell in a Cell, Ultimate Honor, brand new championships. So much happening at SummerSlam. But right now, we're going to find out what's going to happen in this contract signing between these two men. General Manager KK Kwam in the ring. He is going to mediate between these two men. There's a lot of star power in the ring right now between these three men. Kwam says, gentlemen, welcome to the table. The reason I'm having you two sign this contract tonight for the Ultimate Honor match at SummerSlam is once signed, you will both agree to not lay a finger on each other until that event. To try and keep some things under control here in the MPWF. Kwam says, once the contract is signed, if you touch each other before SummerSlam, you will be suspended without pay for 6 months and will not be able to challenge for the MPWF Championship for a year. So with that said, let's sign the contract. Let's get it signed, folks. Let's get it underway here. Ortiz says, I'll sign the contract first. Ivan, you've been afraid of me for a while. You've been afraid of what I've become. I am everything you were and more. I am the best wrestler in the MPWF, and these people know it. They know I take people to Suplex City. And you can hear it from this crowd here. Suplex City chants raining through the entire arena. Ivan Volkov having to grit his teeth through this crowd chanting at him. Ortiz says, I should be the MPWF champion right now. I should have been the first man to ping you, but Klaus robbed me of that. Ultimate Honor is perfect. No rules, no interference. The only way to win is by submission. No one, and I mean no one, will question who is better again. That's what it's all about. That's what we're going to find out at SummerSlam, folks. Kwam saying, thank you for signing the contract, Ortiz, as Ortiz just signed the contract. Ivan, now is the time you need to sign the contract. Ortiz dropped that pen down. He is ready. Ivan says, I'm going to surprise you in the entire world, Ortiz. You are right. These people booed me. They called me boring. They hated my dominance on top, and they cheer you, and they love you, and I hate it, and I hate that stupid Suplex City chat. Ivan Volkov, oh wow. This crowd is going to rain it on Ivan Volkov right now. Ivan says, I don't care about these stupid people, but our peers. Wrestlers started to say that you were better than me. BS. I became the MPWF champion. I proved I was still the best. Still, people believe you are better than me, and it has led to this between us right now. Who is better, Ortiz or Ivan Volkov? Volkov says, I am better than you, Ortiz. My time on the top of core wrestling is far from over. It's one thing you and Ryan Sparks teamed up to defeat me at WrestleMania. It's another to force me to submit. I have never submitted, and I never will. The tension is high, folks. And Ivan Volkov grabbing that contract now to sign it. He is saying he has never been submitted and never will. Oh, wait a minute! Ivan Volkov attacking Angel Ortiz! Wait, he's just got suspended for 6 months! He's just been suspended for 6 months! What is this? What is this? Ivan Volkov now got Ortiz up here. And now, oh my God, just power bombed him through the table. What the hell is this? Ivan Volkov just signed the contract and just took out Angel Ortiz. And now wait a damn minute here. And oh my goodness. Ivan Volkov destroying Ortiz. Kwam screaming at him to stop. And now wait a minute, Ortiz in trouble now. Oh my god, he got powerbombed to the floor. And Kwam now, say you son of a bitch, you're suspended, you're gone. You cannot challenge for the MPWF Championship. Why the hell would Ivan Volkov do this? And Volkov said, I'm not going anywhere. I haven't signed the contract yet. He is weak, and I'm going to destroy him at SummerSlam like I did tonight. Ivan Volkov fake signing the contract so he could get a final shot. And now here he is signing the contract fully. Ivan Volkov is a treacherous bastard, folks. Ivan Volkov getting the last laugh here tonight, getting the final word in before SummerSlam. My God, look at the carnage in the ring, folks. It is going to be ultimate honor at SummerSlam. Ivan Volkov versus Sub-Zero Angel Ramirez Ortiz. Welcome back, folks. We have one more matchup before our main event for the MPWF World Championship here at Annihilation. And introducing next the man who will challenge for the YouTube title at SummerSlam, being accompanied by his manager, Richard Hawkins. Ladies and gentlemen, legit CJ Parker, who is coming to the ring focused and ready here tonight. Brand new theme music for CJ Parker ahead of his gargantuan matchup with JD Emo, Perseverance by Hatebreed. CJ Parker believes he has all the perseverance in the world, and he's going to persevere at SummerSlam and walk away as the YouTube champ. Yeah, what a big time matchup. JD Emo, a legend in core wrestling, making his debut in the Major Pain Wrestling Federation out of one of our biggest shows of all time against one of the best to ever do it in CJ Parker. CJ Parker wants to break his streak of losing at Click Previews. CJ Parker has not got a Click Preview win since he lost the title at MPWF SummerSlam of 2021, ladies and gentlemen. CJ Parker has managed to stay on top, but those Click Preview wins have not come his way. And again, he does not want that to continue with JD Emo. What a big opportunity here for Yamamoto Yoshino, son of the legendary Yamasaki Yoshino, being given a massive chance here against CJ Parker. You know that if Yoshino can pick up a win here tonight against CJ Parker, he has got to be given a matchup at SummerSlam on the buy-in show. Could you imagine knocking off a man right before the YouTube title matchup against one of the greatest in core wrestling's ever seen? And again, Yoshino could do it. Yoshida on any given night could become the best in the world, ladies and gentlemen. He just has to put it all together at the right time, all the time. And again, consistency for Yoshida, that's what he needs. And being in the ring with a man like CJ Parker will bring out the best in him. A former World Wrestling Future Champion, Yoshida is looking to make it big here in 2023. So here we go, folks. Parker and Yoshida. And Yoshida kicking Parker right in the gut there. And like I said, Yoshida is going to come at this matchup as hard and fast as possible. So KK Kwam has given him a big chance and a big test for CJ Parker as well. Like I said, Yoshida is no slouch at all. Parker fights back here. Look at these body blows to Yoshino. Now look at that, Parker getting right in the face of Yoshino. Again, you don't want to waste your time with Yamamoto Yoshino. He knows exactly what he's doing in the ring. So Yamamoto Yoshino is on the same level as the Cypher. We mentioned before, KK Kwam believing in Yoshino, the Cypher, and Jason Holiday as three men that could really be the next step here of the MPWF Annihilation brand. Going around with that waist lock though to CJ Parker. Oh my god, what a vicious backbreaker that was. And like I said, I kind of like this new side of CJ Parker. Getting beaten by his long-term rival and former best friend Chase Stevens at WrestleMania has unlocked a fury and anger in CJ Parker that we haven't seen in quite some time here. And again, he's going to need it against Jamie Emo at SummerSlam. Oh, Yoshino going face first with the buckle. Look at these chops here by Parker. Parker is ragtagging this boy here tonight. And again here, look. And look at how fired up CJ Parker is. I am loving this new CJ Parker. So he puts that forearm right to the face of Yoshino, but a kick out there. Oh my gosh, knee right to the back of the skull. Maybe this was the wrong time for Yoshino to be on the other side of CJ Parker. He's got him up here, and Parker now, Alabama slam! Oh man, that might be it. The back of his head bouncing off the mat, and oh, kick out there by Yoshino though. Yoshino not gonna give up here. Oh my god, that was a hard landing. And Yoshino yelling at this crowd. And then, oh, Yoshino blocked that shot though. And Yoshino fighting back here. And there's a big time front push kick to CJ Parker. I want a kick to the face there. And now Yoshino gonna fight back here in this matchup. And now Yoshino's got him up here for the suplex. And no, he drops him there with a gourd buster. And now Yoshino heading to the top rope here. And Yoshino waiting for CJ Parker to get to his feet. Yoshino up the top and beautiful double axe handle. And now whipping Parker into the ropes. Yoshino now, oh my god, what a reverse. So he released German suplex. And even Richard Hawkins reacted to that one on the outside. And now Yoshino gonna go for the Osaka Street Cutter, and he hits it. Osaka Street Cutter, wait a damn minute. Richard Hawkins getting up and distracting the referee. And that is something Jamie Emo is gonna have to watch out for at SummerSlam. Is that man on the outside of the ring, Richard Hawkins? Parker has to count his lucky stars there. Oh, kick to the gut though. Again, look at these strikes here, and what a head kick there by CJ Parker. That distraction might have been enough by Richard Hawkins there. So CJ Parker utilizes the Swanton Bomb and the Anaconda Vice. Two very dangerous maneuvers here, and he's got Yoshino up here. Wow, what a flapjack there. And that might be all she wrote in this matchup. Parker now going for the cover on Yoshino. Two. And oh, Yoshino kicks out though. Yoshino not done yet. And Parker now sending Yoshino into the buckle. And oh, went for the step-up knee. Yoshino moved out the way. And now Yoshino, look at this, going for the body shots here with the knees. And now, oh my goodness, another one right to the chest. And now, out of crescent kick to the back of the skull. And Yoshino back to the top rope again. And Yoshino is feeling it here. He's waiting for Parker to get up and down. Oh my goodness! A meteora off the top rope by Yamamoto. Yoshino with the cover. Two and all kick out. Close one there, but stay on top of him. Stay on top of him. You have CJ Parker reeling right now. Oh wait, block shot though by Parker. What a drop kick. What a drop kick by the former MPWF champion. But Yoshino though gets back up. And Yoshino, oh wait. Parker moved out the way of that kick. And now CJ Parker went out of car device. No, Yoshino saw it coming. Yoshino reverses it. And now Yoshino. Oh, what a side slam. And now, look at this here. Yamamoto Yoshino got a sharpshooter applied on CJ Parker. Sharpshooter applied. And Parker in trouble. And this crowd is loving Yoshino. Like I said, this kid put himself on the map here tonight against CJ Parker, but Parker able to escape. And wait, no. Block shot by Yoshino. Yoshino go for that front push kick, but oh, CJ Parker saw it coming. And that one bent the knee because Yoshino had to grab the ropes in order to keep standing. And now look at this here. Springboard suplex. And now Parker to the top rope here. And CJ Parker looking to finish Yoshino. There's the Swanton Bomb. Swanton Bomb by CJ Parker. 2-3, and CJ Parker gets the win in a very good matchup. Big momentum for CJ Parker before SummerSlam. What a great back and forth matchup. Yoshino, look at that meteor off the top rope. Tried his best. That sharpshooter was locked in tight. But against CJ Parker, a master of submissions, able to escape. And there was the picture perfect Swanton Bomb that CJ Parker was able to hit. And he gets the victory here before SummerSlam. Like I said, this is a very, very different CJ Parker we are seeing here. He might go all the way and win the YouTube title. Wait a minute. Hawkins berating Yamamoto Yoshino. And CJ Parker now going after Yamamoto Yoshino. Going to attack him. Now there's absolutely no need for this. There is absolutely no need for this at all. CJ Parker is beside himself. Jamie Emo appearing once again here, distracting CJ Parker. Ladies and gentlemen, what a night SummerSlam is going to be. Right now, we're going to take a look at some of the matches that will be taking place. Once again, the theme song for SummerSlam is The Perfume of Decay by Tiger Cub. But let's head right now to see all the matches that have been scheduled thus far for MPWF SummerSlam. The YouTube title will be on the line. CJ Parker will go one-on-one with Jamie Emo. As well as we found out on our previous episode of MPWF War, Antonio Gomez will challenge the new North American champion, Shane Carter. Atari and Sasha Fierce, the legacy, will meet Destruction, Francais, Bartlett, and DuPont to become the first ever MPWF Women's Tag Team Champions. Announced tonight, the Young Ones, Christian Paul and Young Mike, will meet Team Bloodshed. The Triple Threat Undisputed Championship match, Ingrid versus Angelina Peace versus Justice Fitzgerald. It will be Ultimate Honor, Angel Ortiz versus Ivan Volkov at MPWF SummerSlam. Someone is going to tap out. And our main event for the Call World Championship, it will be Sean Stevens versus the champion Max Payne. If Sean Stevens loses, his career is over. And wait a minute, we're back here with Richard Hawkins. And Hawkins says, Jamie Emo, you think it's cute to post that stupid video every episode? You think you're a big shot? CJ Parker is going to destroy you at SummerSlam and become the new MPWF YouTube champion. We are about to dominate Annihilation. Hawkins is very confident in his man, CJ Parker. He says, on episode 3, I'm going to embarrass the Cypher once again and become the FJCW Eastern champion. I think it's time Japan got legit. Don't you see, Ryan? We are taking over. The Young Ones are going to win the MPWF Tag Team Championships at SummerSlam. That's right, Christian Paul still associated with Richard Hawkins. Just cheered by the fans. Hawkins saying, this could be yours, Ryan, all of yours. The Void, we can deal with them. Lethal, who's going to turn on you, we can deal with him. Ivan and Ortiz, we can deal with them. Become a legend, become legit. Richard Hawkins is going into full Get Ryan Sparks on Board mode here, ladies and gentlemen, because coming up next is our main event for the MPWF World's Heavyweight Championship. This could be the scary future of MPWF Annihilation. Benson Clement has the opportunity tonight to become the MPWF World Champion before SummerSlam. Right now, he is in control of the darkness and the void. He defeated Helios Christ at WrestleMania. We still don't know the full ramifications of what happened to Helios Christ. In beating Helios Christ at WrestleMania, Benson Clement was able to turn Systematic Carnage and Sick Nick to his side, creating the new void here on Annihilation. We haven't heard from Helios Christ since WrestleMania. Benson Clement said, what is a god without followers? What is a king without his crown? He owns the darkness, but his crown is the MPWF World Championship. And he looks to take it here tonight. That is a deranged individual, ladies and gentlemen. The vampire of the night turned god of the darkness. We may be in the darkest timeline of the MPWF if he can win tonight. We are going to have to pray that Ryan Sparks has a plan for this match. Peace out! Matt, what an ovation there. You see that crowd pump up? You saw that crowd pump up? They are ready for the MPWF World Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Sparks, the MPWF World Champion. Many people might think he has got an opportunity to defeat Benson Clement tonight, but Ryan Sparks has been defying the odds his entire career here in the MPWF. He competed in the crawl contest and didn't win it, but persevered, continued, fought through everything. He lost to Lethal Mathematics at WrestleMania 9, fought through that, won the Money in the Bank briefcase, became the MPWF World Champion, lost the title to Ivan Volkov, showed up at WrestleMania, and defeated Angel Ortiz and Ivan Volkov for the same night to become a two-time MPWF Champion. If anyone can stop Benson Clement in a wrestling match, it's that man right there, main event, Ryan Sparks. And he has to. If he wants to defend that title at SummerSlam against Lethal Mathematics, he has to. Once you put Ryan Sparks in a corner, that man will come out swinging, folks. What a big time, big fight feel we have here tonight. Our main event here. Benson Clement versus Ryan Sparks. Again, you can feel the tension here for our main event. This crowd firmly on that man's side right there. The current reigning and defending MPWF World Champion. So here we go. Both men have seen the belt. Who is going to walk away as the MPWF Champion here tonight? I know Benson Clement going to play mind games, and Ryan Sparks ain't doing none of that. He said, we ain't playing no mind or darkness games here tonight. And oh, man. I have no idea what Ryan's got planned, but I hope he's got something. Because Benson Clement is going to be no easy feat here tonight. And, oh, my God, I'll go right to the skull there of Ryan Sparks and Benson Clement now. Again, completely invigorated from WrestleMania. You saw how well he did against Ivan Volkov on our previous episode. And Ryan now fighting back here. And Ryan and Lethal got beat up by The Void, Systematic Carnage, and Sick Nick to end the show on episode one. And here we are now, Ryan trying to retain the championship, and he sends Benson Clement to the outside of the ring. What Ryan cannot do is get overzealous against a crafty individual like Benson Clement, just like that. Benson Clement, again, just like we've mentioned with Shane Carter and other competitors, we don't know the full extent, the full potential of Benson Clement. The fact that that man was able to walk into WrestleMania and defeat Helios Christ puts him on a level second to very few people, folks. And now what's he doing here? He is just dominating Ryan Sparks right now. And now Ryan Sparks goes face first onto the steel ring steps. And like I said, yeah, having a brawl on the outside with Benson Clement probably isn't what Ryan Sparks wants to do here. Probably not how he wants to start off this title matchup. I'll tell you that right now. And now look at that snap suplex there into the quick cover there by Benson Clement. But Ryan kicks out. And now, oh my God, what a Pele kick. And Benson Clement is dominating here in this title matchup. He is giving Ryan Sparks zero breathing room. And Clement now driving a knee right to the face. Ryan in big trouble here. Big time trouble. Two, and oh, he kicks out. Now Clement grabbing Ryan Sparks. Now look at that, singling out that arm, double foot stomp, trying to hyperextend the arm. We heard it earlier by Richard Hawkins. It was that arm that was broken by Lethal Mathematics 2 years ago. And that's something both of these men are going to be thinking about. We already know that Lethal will be challenging for the title at SummerSlam as Ryan Sparks fights back. Each scenario is extremely different, but it's all for the same thing. The richest prize in the MPWF on MPWF Annihilation, as I should say, the World Championship. And a beautiful German suplex there, but a rope break by Benson Clement. So what a night it's been here. We opened up the proceedings with an incredible matchup between Lethal Mathematics and the Cypher. Then a hardcore title match that saw the debut of T-Dot here on Annihilation. We found out the Young Ones are going to battle Team Bloodshed for the tag titles at SummerSlam. We know the finals of the Women's Tag Title Tournament, the Legacy vs. Destruction, Fraud Say, and we're going to have a three-way dance for the Undisputed Women's Championship. CJ Parker is on fire, as so is Ryan Sparks, as he has Benson Clement up, and he slams him for the TKO there. And Ryan, I'll go for the cover, but not hooking the leg, and that wasn't smart. Come on, Ryan, you got to stay focused on this matchup here with Benson Clement. Clement now got Ryan, oh my goodness, sling blade here, and drop kick right to the face, right to the mush. And Clement now got Ryan back up here. Ryan in trouble, he's on the ropes. And I, wait a minute, what is this? Benson Clement throwing Ryan Sparks outside. Ryan actually lands on his feet, and oh my god, what the hell was that? Is that the powers that the darkness gives you? Are we going to have a new MPWF champion when this is all said and done here tonight? Benson Clement just dove over the top rope of Ryan Sparks, and this crowd is going nuts right now. This is all Benson Clement right now in this match. Like I said, Ryan, you better have a plan. But Benson Clement is looking for that choke. If he hits that choke, we're having a new MPWF champion right here and now. The fairy tale has ended, but no, Ryan reverses. And oh, Ryan! Oh my god! Sparks effect! Sparks effect on Benson Clement! And oh, Ryan to retain the title! Two! And oh, Benson Clement gets the shoulder up. Like I said, just like that, this is... He wasn't able to get the three count off that one. But it's stuff like that that has had Ryan Sparks continue to be successful, to continue to get to this point here in the MPWF. Now he sends Clement to the outside, but Clement hangs on. And oh, Clement fights back though against Ryan Sparks. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your main event for the MPWF World Championship. The winner will meet Lethal Mathematics at MPWF SummerSlam as Ryan knocks Benson Clement off the top rope. Ryan Sparks now heading the top rope himself, and he hits the elbow drop. Big time, full on flush. Hooks a leg here on Benson Clement, two and a kick out. My God here, Ryan, you gotta pick him up. You gotta hit him with another Sparks effect. And now Ryan again, ravaging Benson Clement. Now what's the MPWF champion thinking? What's going on in his mind? He's got something planned for Benson Clement. And Ryan out, what a net breaker. What a net breaker by Ryan Sparks. And now wait, went for that big shot. Big right hand, and Clement saw it coming. And now wait a minute. Oh no, this is not good. Oh no, this is not good. Big time full Nelson slam there by Benson Clement, but Ryan Sparks kicks out. Ryan proving he ain't done yet in this main event. Oh, an elbow there by Clement. So people are biting their fingernails right now. Are we going to have a new champion? And look at this here. Look at how savage this beatdown is by Benson Clement to Ryan Sparks. Clement picking Sparks back up now. Now what is he going for here? We already saw that dive to the outside of the ring. And Clement now with a shot at Ryan. Pulling it down the ropes. Sending Clement to the floor. Ryan quickly jumping to the top rope here. Ryan Sparks going to go up the top. And there's the elbow to the floor. There's the elbow to the floor. And no wasted motion. Ryan Sparks taking Benson Clement down here. And there's a net breaker to the floor. You see, Ryan Sparks ain't taunting. He ain't trying to get the crowd's adulation. He's trying to retain his MPWF title. Throwing Benson Clement in the ring. And now Ryan wants the Sparks effect. He wants to finish it here. And oh wait, he's got him up. What is this? What is this? Oh my God, trying to break his neck. Ryan now hooking the leg here on Benson Clement. Two. And oh, Clement gets the shoulder up. Ryan now taking advantage of this momentum he has, and what a boot there by Ryan Sparks, taking down Benson Clement. Ryan is staying focused, but wait a minute, Clement just sat up there, and oh man, what is Ryan going to do? What is he going to do here? He's already bleeding, he's already been in a war here, and Clement just keeps coming back, and oh my gosh. Ryan is in trouble because Benson Clement might be looking to take Ryan Sparks into the void. And now he has him. And oh my goodness, and there it is, into the void. Ryan Sparks is down. We have a brand new MPWF champion. My God. Oh wait. Ryan Sparks got the shoulder up, but he didn't even get up. That took everything he had. And now wait, Ryan, desperately trying to fight back, and there's a knee. There's no quit, regardless of what Richard Hawkins wants to say, regardless of what he wants to do, there's no quit in Ryan Sparks. He will fight to his very last breath. And there's that double axe handle. And Ryan now going right back to the top rope again. Ryan is fighting off pure adrenaline, pure epinephrine. Ryan now again knocking down Benson Clement. And now he wants the Sparks effect. And oh wait, no, he doesn't go for it. He's got Benson Clement up, and oh my gosh, a suplex to a knee right to the face to finish him off. A new move, and oh, Clement gets the shoulder up. What a matchup this is for the MPWF World Championship. Ryan Sparks now may be looking for that TKO once again on Benson Clement. He's gonna run. There's the big time knee. Clement is down. He's got him up on his shoulders, and there it is. TKO, and here we go. Sparks effect. Ryan got him. Sparks effect on Benson Clement. Right. Oh, wait a damn minute. The power of the darkness of Ryan Sparks looking around, confused as to what just happened. And oh, wait a minute. Benson Clement getting to his feet. And oh, sling blade. Ryan Sparks was unaware. And now, oh no, what a slap there. Benson Clement, and now look at who is watching from the crowd. Systematic Carnage. And as well as Systematic Carnage, there's Sick Nick, as they're about to watch the leader of the darkness be crowned the new MPWF champion. Oh man. There's no way Ryan Sparks can kick out of two of these. There's no way he can kick out of two of these. And again, with the looming threat of Systematic Carnage and Sick Nick. And oh no. Here it comes into the void for the second time to Ryan Sparks. And Benson Clement now to become the MPWF. away from Mathematics, behind Sick Nick. Wait a damn minute. And Lethal now going after Sick Nick here. Lethal helping out his partner and a member of the Future Foundation in Ryan Sparks. Lethal showing no bias. He's going to help Ryan try to get to SummerSlam so they can face each other for the MPWF title. Oh, wait a minute. Lethal Mathematics now setting Sick Nick to the backstage area. Benson Clement watching on here. And now Lethal, basic addition there to Sick Nick, taking it down. And a referee now trying to stop these two men from fighting. It is pandemonium right now. The referee with Sick Nick and Lethal Mathematics leaving Benson Clement and Ryan inside the ring. And oh my God! Is that who I think it is? Helios Christ is behind Systematic Carnage. And Helios Christ taking out Systematic Carnage. Wait a minute here. Helios Christ is back after WrestleMania. And the referee now following these two men. And Christ taking out Carnage here. We haven't seen him since WrestleMania. But Helios Christ looks different. He looks more human. And now wait a minute. Carnage in trouble. Helios Christ has him up now. Powerbomb. And Christ powerbombing him through the table. Helios Christ setting him to the depths of hell. The referee now to check on Systematic Carnage. Helios Christ jumping the barricade. Clever not realizing. Helios Christ here. Kick to the gut. Oh my God. Death of Jason Rage, Helios Christ, and he drops Benson Clement with it. Oh, man, this is crazy. This is crazy, folks. Helios Christ now getting outside the ring before the referee can see what has happened. The referee running back, and Helios Christ taking out Benson Clement. My God, and now Ryan Sparks. Ryan Sparks waiting for Benson Clement to get up. And now, setting him into the buckle. He's taken two Sparks effects. The death of Jason Rage. And now Ryan Sparks has Benson Clement up here. And Sparks now going for the Brain Buster on the top rope. But there's the Brain Buster. The Brain Buster by the MPWF champion. Ryan Sparks falling into the cover. Two. And Ryan Sparks has done it once again. Once again, folks. Oh my goodness. With the assist from Lethal Mathematics and Helios Christ, Ryan Sparks has retained the MPWF World Championship. What a main event here for MPWF Annihilation. Oh my gosh, folks. Ryan could barely even stand after that one, folks. What a main event. What a champion. What a champion. Persevering, fighting through everything. Ryan Sparks defeats Benson Clement here tonight to retain the MPWF World Championship. Can't believe that Helios Christ is back. You know there's going to be repercussions for Helios Christ. Look at the bloody, battered, bruised Ryan Sparks, still the MPWF World Champion here tonight. What a nuts episode of MPWF Annihilation this has been here, ladies and gentlemen. I can't put over Ryan Sparks enough. That's the man that is leading this brand. That's the man that's leading Annihilation. Wait a minute. Lethal Mathematics getting in the ring and Lethal confronting Ryan Sparks. Because now we know that at SummerSlam, it will be Lethal versus Ryan number three. The rubber match, the finale for the MPWF World Championship. Lethal won at WrestleMania 9, Ryan Sparks won at Clash of Champions, and finally, who is the better man? We will find out, from bitter rivals to best friends, for the MPWF Championship, Lethal Mathematics versus Ryan Sparks at SummerSlam. It's for that right there, folks. And again, thank you for watching MPWF Annihilation, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Dwayne James, Johnny Feelgood. I'm signing out, and that is your MPWF title matchup at SummerSlam.